What is good, everybody? It is week 14 of the fantasy football season, the final week before we get into these fantasy football playoffs. We want to help you guys get a win here this week. So I got my top 36 rankings for the wide receiver position. We're going to do the running back position here later today. So make sure you are subscribed to this channel. That way you don't miss that video when it comes out. But like I said, top 36 wide receivers in today's video. Without wasting any more time, let's hop right into the video and let's start talking about these tiers. All right, so I got seven tiers to get through all 36 wide receivers here in today's video, going from wide receiver one all the way to wide receiver 36. We're going to be kicking it off in my tier one. My tier one is those elite wide receiver ones here on the week 14 slate. We got Jamar Chase, Justin Jefferson, AJ Brown, and Amon-Ra St. Brown to round out this tier. Really not much to talk about when it comes to these players. These are the elite wide receivers of fantasy football. Obviously, we are must starting these guys every single week. There is no real debate on whether or not we are sitting these guys. Just a couple matchups I wanted to talk about. The first one being Justin Jefferson's matchup there at the number two spot. He gets a matchup here this week against Atlanta. It is a good matchup on paper right now. Atlanta is averaging 3.9 fantasy points above the expectation, and they're allowing 31.1 fantasy points per game, which is 26th in the NFL. So on paper, this should be a pretty good matchup for Justin Jefferson. You also have some good narrative in this one, the return of Kirk Cousins to US Bank Stadium. So we'll see how that one goes here in this matchup against the Falcons. Now, the other matchup that I want to talk about is Amon-Ra St. Brown. He plays on Thursday Night Football. It is a bad matchup on paper. Green Bay, they are allowing negative 3.6 fantasy points below the expectations, so they are a little bit tougher against those fantasy football wide receivers, only allowing about 24 fantasy points per game to the position group as a whole, which is the sixth best in the NFL. Amon-Ra, like I said, a must-start player anyways. He is matchup proof. It is a bad matchup on paper, but just wanted to bring that one up just because he may score a tiny bit below what you expect him to do here this week because of the matchup. Now let's move on to my tier two. Tier two has three players in it. These are the high end wide receiver ones. I got Puka Nacua, Mike Evans, and CeeDee Lamb in this tier here. Really, the only player that I want to talk about at length in this tier is going to be CeeDee Lamb. Couple of things to bring up. One, he is questionable this week with a shoulder injury. He's kind of been questionable over the last couple of weeks. He continues to keep playing. I expect him to keep playing until we know otherwise. So right now I do have him as a projected play in my lineup this week. He does also have a good matchup this week. So he plays the Cincinnati Bengals, currently giving up 4.1 fantasy points above the expectation, ranked 22nd in fantasy points allowed, giving up 29.3 fantasy points per game to the wide receiver group. Even though it's Cooper Rush, he should still have the ability to score some fantasy football points. And I still have him as a wide receiver one here in week 14. Now let's go to tier three. Tier three is the low end wide receiver ones, and I got a total of five guys here in this tier. We're going to kick it off with Drake London, followed by George Pickens, T. Higgins, Cooper Kupp, and Tyreek Hill. That is the entire tier for me. Two good matchups at the top of this tier, Drake London and George Pickens. Drake London, he plays on the road at the Minnesota Vikings, like we said. One thing to note, Minnesota has been horrible against wide receivers so far this year. They rank dead last in fantasy points allowed, giving up 34.9 fantasy points per game. You still have that narrative, like I said, Kirk Cousins revenge. Maybe he's going to be trying to throw the football. Also played pretty poor last week, so wants to kind of get that behind him. And when you look at the fantasy points above the expectation, they're giving up about 6.4 fantasy points above the expectation, Minnesota that is. So Drake London should have the opportunity to score big here in week 14. Now, like I said, George Pickens also has a good matchup. Right now, that matchup against Cleveland, they're giving up 5.7 fantasy points above the expectation, currently ranked 29th in the NFL, giving up 32.7 fantasy points per game to the wide receiver group. So George Pickens, he didn't have the biggest of games when they played just a couple of weeks ago. He should have the opportunity to have a big game here this week. And everybody else in this tier, good low-end wide receiver one plays. Now let's go to tier four. I am going to talk about five guys in this tier, kicking it off at 13 with Malik Nabers. Then you have Calvin Ridley, Jaxon Smith-Njigba, Ladd McConkey, and DJ Moore. This is my high-end wide receiver two tier. There's a couple guys I want to talk about here. The first one being Calvin Ridley. He gets a matchup against the Jacksonville Jaguars. You also have that kind of revenge game narrative here in this one as well. Obviously, it's a good matchup on paper. They're giving 5.7 fantasy points above the expectation right now, currently ranked 31st in fantasy points allowed to wide receivers with 33.3 fantasy points per game. So Calvin Ridley should have the opportunity to score a lot of points against his former team here in the Jacksonville Jaguars. They also have Ladd McConkey coming in at 16. I want to talk about him because he's questionable with a knee injury. Still waiting on some more information about that. Jim Harbaugh said he's going to get checked out. I do expect him to play, so we will see if he does end up getting that official activation. If he does play, he does fit into this high-end wide receiver 2 play for me because Ladd McConkey has been damn good down the stretch for the Los Angeles Chargers. And then you have DJ Moore. I want to talk about him. He gets a game against the San Francisco 49ers on the road. This is a bad matchup on paper. They're allowing 4 points below the expectation right now, so not really giving up a ton of extra points to wide receivers. And they rank 8th against the wide receiver position, only allowing 24.9 fantasy points per game, so it should be a little bit tougher. Obviously, Caleb Williams has been a lot better since the offensive coordinator change. Now you have the head coaching change. That offensive coordinator had been promoted from the passing game coordinator to the OC to now the head coach. There's a lot going on here in Chicago, but they have been playing some better football. DJ Moore sneaks in here as a high-end wide receiver too, despite the tough matchup. Now, tier 5, we have a lot of players to talk about. I have a total of 7 in this tier. These are the low-end wide receiver 2. So going from wide receiver 18 all the way to 24, I got Jacoby Myers, Marvin Harrison Jr., Garrett Wilson, Jaden Reed, DK Metcalf, Khalil Shakir, and Devontae Adams. That rounds out that entire tier for me. I got 4 guys specifically we need to talk about. Jacoby Myers, he has a great matchup this week against Tampa Bay. Right now, they're allowing 3.5 fantasy points above the expectation. They're currently ranked 25th in overall points allowed at 31 fantasy points per game. We've seen that Tampa Bay last week, they gave up a big game to Adam Thielen. They might be giving up a big game here this week to Jacoby Myers as well. So he's a player that I'd be trying to plug into my lineups if I have him on my fantasy football teams. Now, Garrett Wilson and Devontae Adams, the New York Jets. On paper, this is a bad matchup against the Miami Dolphins. They are going to be on the road there in Miami. Miami's giving up negative 3.5 fantasy points below the expectation, only allowing 22.5 fantasy points per game. That is the second best in the NFL. So they've been pretty damn good against the wide receiver position. Could be a tougher game for both of these guys. Obviously, the Jets just haven't been playing good football either. So you kind of have to put that into the equation as well. And then DK Metcalf, we'll talk about him. He's questionable with a knee injury, still been questionable, banged up a couple of weeks ago, still been dealing with the same type of stuff. I think he's probably going to play in this matchup. Feels like he's on the injury report every week and then he goes out and plays, but DK Metcalf hasn't been that great over the last couple of weeks either. I'm wondering if this knee injury and some of these other injuries that he's been dealing with have been affecting him, and that's maybe why you're seeing them go to JSN a little bit more than they typically have in the past. Maybe JSN is also just emerging, but I think that's something to note. But DK Metcalf, I do expect him to play, and if he plays, he is a low-end wide receiver 2 for me here in this week's matchups. Now let's go to tier 6. Tier 6, I got 6 wide receivers in this tier, and this is going to be the high-end wide receiver 3s. Kicking off at wide receiver 25, Brian Thomas Jr., 26, Jerry Jeudy, 27, Keenan Allen, 28, Jameson Williams, Darnell Mooney, and then the last but not least, Juwan Jennings. This tier has a ton of matchups to talk about. On paper, there's a ton of bad matchups in this tier. Let's just start it off at 25. Brian Thomas Jr., he gets the Tennessee Titans on the road, currently allowing 3.3 fantasy points below the expectation there in Tennessee, averaging 24.3 fantasy points allowed per game. 7th best in the NFL. Should be a little bit of a tougher matchup for Brian Thomas Jr. Also, probably right back to Mac Jones under center here. So Jerry Jeudy gets the Pittsburgh Steelers. That's a bad matchup on paper as well. 3.7 fantasy points below the expectation, only allowing 25 fantasy points per game to wide receivers. 10th best in the NFL. Obviously, we saw how this turned out the last couple of weeks when they did play just a few weeks ago. This is a tougher divisional matchup, but Jerry Jeudy, he's been playing some good ball, and Jameis Winston slinging the football around the football field. So Jerry Jeudy still has some upside, but a bad matchup on paper. Keenan Allen, just like I mentioned with DJ Moore, he gets that bad matchup against San Francisco, 4 points below the expectation, currently ranked 8th in fantasy points allowed. Jameson Williams, he gets the bad matchup on Thursday Night Football that we talked about with Amon-Ra St. Brown. The only difference is Jameson Williams is not matchup proof like Amon-Ra is, so this could affect him a little bit more depending on the coverages that he sees. Darnell Mooney, the one positive spot in this tier, he does get the good matchup like we mentioned with Drake London against Minnesota, dead last against fantasy football wide receivers, allowing 6.4 fantasy points above the expectation, should have the opportunity to exceed his expectations here this week. And then Juwan Jennings also gets that bad matchup this week against Chicago. They're currently ranked 4th against the fantasy football wide receiver position, only allowing 23.8 fantasy points per game and allowing negative 4.1 fantasy points below the expectation. A tougher matchup for Juwan Jennings and the San Francisco 49ers. So that tier in general, a lot of talented players, a lot of matchups that I don't love on paper this week. But let's go to tier 7. This is the last tier. This is the low end wide receiver 3s. I got 6 wide receivers in this tier that we can talk about. We are going to have DeAndre Hopkins, Jordan Addison, Amari Cooper, Jalen Waddle, Debo Samuel, and Devontae Smith, and that is that entire tier. Again, we can talk about the Jordan Addison matchup. That is going to be Atlanta, like I mentioned with Justin Jefferson, a good matchup on paper, allowing 3.9 fantasy points above the expectation, 26th against fantasy football wide receivers. Should have some opportunities for some bigger plays for Jordan Addison, but he's still a boom bust guy, going to be a low end wide receiver receiver 3 for me in my official rankings. Deebo Samuel gets the tough matchup just like Juwan Jennings. The issue is Deebo Samuel has been very, very, very disappointing over the last couple of weeks. He's being out-targeted by Juwan Jennings, working behind George Kittle in the offense. You now have Isaac Garendo running the football, so maybe, just maybe, they start using Deebo Samuel a little bit more in the receiving game, maybe a little bit more in the rushing game. It's going to be tough to tell right now. It's hard for me to have any confidence starting Deebo Samuel, and I do have a league where I have to start Deebo Samuel, and I do not feel good about it this week, coming in as my wide receiver 35. And last but not least, I had to throw him on the list. Currently questionable with a hamstring. We do not know if he's going to play. He's missed the last couple of weeks. Devontae Smith there at number 36. I think if he does get activated before this game and he does play in this game, I will be moving him up the rankings. I just wanted to put him in here as the last guy so we could talk about him. If he plays, I'm going to probably be moving him up into that low-end wide receiver 2 tier around that DK Metcalf, Jaden Reed, Davante Adams type of range. So that is a good matchup on paper for him against Carolina. If he's activated, I'll have a little bit more confidence, but we still don't know at the time of this recording if he's going to be active in this game. So there you have it, folks. That's my top 36 wide receivers here in week 14 of the fantasy football season. Hopefully you guys are already subscribed to the channel. That way you can catch the running back version of this video when it does come out later today. If you're not subscribed already, hit the subscribe button. If you found something actionable, entertaining, informative, anything in this video that you liked, hit the like button for me as well. It is the best free way to show this channel some support. And last but not least, make sure you go join that Discord. There is a free Discord linked in the description for you to join. 270 plus people in there that want to talk fantasy football with you, help you win your fantasy football championships, and maybe you can find some future league mates, some homies just to talk fantasy football with, whatever it may be. It's a dope community. Want you to be a part of it. And like I said, it's free to join, so there is no risk in doing that. But with all of that out of the way, nothing else for you today. So I will see you on our next episode. But until then, peace out.